What's up, everyone, and welcome to the club. In today's video, we're creating a sketch illustration of a cat. Let's get started by sketching a large circle in the center of our page. We use a side grip using the flat edge of our pencil. Let's start at the very top in the middle. Just gonna work our way around the left side. Back in towards the center. And go around the right side. Now we're gonna add some guidelines to help with the symmetry. Let's start at the very top of our circle. We're gonna sketch a line coming all the way down towards the bottom of our page, and then back up towards the top. Now we're gonna add another guideline going across from left to right. Now with our guidelines in place, we're gonna block out the eyes. Let's leave a gap in between the eyes, starting over on the left side. We're gonna sketch a circle, going around, and then back in. And we'll do the same thing on the right, drawing that same size circle. Let's split the circles in half. Starting from the very top, we're going to sketch a line coming down on either side. And we'll pull the pupils towards the inside of that center line. So let's start on the left, stepping in. It's going to curve this in towards that line, and down towards the bottom. Go back up to the top. Curve this in and then down. Let's do the same thing on the right. Let's go back to that center line and block in the nose. We're going to start over on the left. It's going to curve the nose going up and then down. And then from the ends, we're going to angle down and in towards that center line. Let's go back up to the inside of the eye. We're just going to curve this in and then down towards the outside corners of the nose. And then from the bottom tip of the nose, we're gonna step down and curve the left side of the mouth. Coming down and then out. Do the same thing on the right. Now we're gonna move out and block out the side of the muzzle. On the outside corner of the nose, we're gonna step up. Just gonna curve this out and then down. Line this up on the right. And then we'll pull this down and in toward that center line, just underneath the bottom of the circle. Let's go all the way up to the top and block in the ears. We're going to start by lining up with the center of the pupil, all the way up towards the top of the circle. Curve this up, and then out. Line this up on the right, and do the same thing. Now from the tip of the ear, come straight down, and just bend that in towards the side of the circle. And once we're happy with the general proportions, I'm going to go back and lightly erase some of these guidelines. Now we're going to create three different shades for the fur. Starting from the eye, we're going to curve this out and down towards the left side of the circle. Do the same thing on the right. Let's go to the inside of the right eye, curve this in and up toward the middle. Sketch a line going up just underneath the top of that circle. And then from the top of that line, curve this out and then down on the left. Do the same thing on the right. Now let's go back up to the top and round out the tip of the ears. We're gonna start on the inside on the left. Let's go round this out and then come down. And we'll go back and erase out the tip of those ears. Let's go back with the tip of our pencil and darken up the center of the pupil. Just gonna trace out the contour. And then we'll fill those in. Now we're going to go in and darken up the outside edge of the iris. You can see that I'm just sloping this down along the top, coming in, and we'll extend this in towards that line across the nose. Then going in with the side edge of our pencil, we're just going to darken up the inside of the iris. I'm just going to leave a little bit of white on the top right side of the eye. That'll be for the highlight. Now going back and adding a drop shadow along the top. Just darkening that up and just fading that out as we come down. Adding a little bit of shadow along the inside. We'll just extend the fur coming out from the side of the eyes using the side edge of our pencil and just feathering that out as we come down. Now we're going down and just adding some detail to the nose. I'm just going back and adding a little bit of shadow on the inside of the eyes, going in towards the center. Now we're going to work the fur around the outside of the muzzle. Starting on the left side, we're just going to lightly pull these lines going out. And just bending that down and in towards the chin. And then we'll add those whisker lines along the side, starting on the left. Just gonna wiggle our pencil, just pull that in, just fade that out. Do the same thing on the right. Let's add another one just up above, just angling this down and in. And then along the bottom, angle in and up. Now I'm just gonna go back and add a shadow across the muzzle. Now we're gonna move out and start working the fur around the cheeks. Let's start on the left. Just gonna pull these going out and down, just working with that curve of that circle. And just tuck that in behind the chin. And we'll add a shadow on the left side, starting from this curve. Just gonna darken this up in towards the side of the muzzle. And we'll just fade that out. And just going back with the tip of our pencil, I'm just going to refine the edge of that fur. And we'll continue building that fur along the top of the head. Let's add that first color block along the top of the eyes. We're going to start on the left. Just going to lightly shade this in. Just working with that curve. Just go up towards the top. And then from that center line, we're just going to work our way out towards the right. And then going back and just refining the edge of the fur. Just adding a little bit of texture along the inside. And then we'll add a darker patch along the outside of the head. And just using the side edge of our pencil. And we'll just blend that in towards the inside and outside. And just pulling that dark fur towards the inside. Now we're just going to refine the shape of the ears. And as we get closer to the end of our drawing, I'm going to darken up my contrast and add a little bit more detail. And that's pretty much it. There's a sketch illustration of a cat. I hope you enjoyed today's lesson. Make sure you subscribe and send me your requests in the comments below. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you again soon.